Given 4 meters wide rectangular channel having a discharge of 20 meter cube per second at a depth of flow of 2 meters, let us find Floyd number that is equal to V by under root of G into Y for a rectangular channel, that is Q by base width into height into root GY, that is equal to 220 by height is 2 into base width is 4 into root G is 9.81 into height is 2, which is 0.564 less than 1, so subcritical flow. Let us find the maximum depth of hum for which the upstream water level will not change or choking condition will not occur, which will be equal to E1 minus EC. We can obtain that from this graph, where this is EC and this is E1. This is delta Z max. So E1 minus EC will be delta Z max, which will be equal to where E1 is Y1 plus Q square by 2G into, we know V is equal to Q by area A square, minus EC is 1.5 YC, which will be equal to Y1 is 2 plus Q is 20 square by 2 into G is 9.81 into area will be equal to 4 into 2 whole square minus 1.5 into YC is Q square by G whole power 1 by 3 for rectangular channel. Q is capital Q by B, capital Q is 20 by B is 4 whole square by 9.81 whole power 1 by 3. Delta Z max will be 0.2696 meters. First case, delta Z is given as 0.33 meters, which is greater than delta Z max. So, upstream energy becomes E1 dash and upstream depth of water level rises to Y1 dash from Y1. And Y2 will be critical, that is YC2, which is equal to Q square by G whole power 1 by 3, which will be equal to 1.366 meters, from which E2 will be equal to EC2, which is 1.5 YC, which is equal to 2.05 meters. So E1 dash will be equal to E2 plus delta Z. That is equal to E2 is critical 2.05 plus delta Z is 0.33, which will be equal to 2.378 meters. So Y1 dash plus Q square by 2G Y1 dash square will be equal to 2.378 meters. That implies Y1 dash plus Q is capital Q by B, that is 4, 20 by 4, that is 5 square by 2 into G is 9.81 into Y1 dash square equal to 2.378, from which Y1 dash will be 2.086 meters. So the upstream water depth will be 2.086 meters, that is Y1 dash, and downstream water depth will be critical depth Y2, that is equal to YC2, which will be 1.366 meters. In the second case, delta Z is given as 0.2 meters, which is less than delta Z max. So no choking condition will occur. Y1 will be 0.2 meters only, which is given. And we need to find E2 and corresponding Y2. From the specific energy curve, this will be E1 and this will be E2 less than E1, and this will be delta Z. So E2 will be E1 minus delta Z. E1 will be Y1, that is 2, plus Q square, that is q square, that is 5 square by 2g, g is 9.81, into y2 square minus delta z is 0.2, which will be 2.12 meters. Corresponding y2 will be y2 plus small q square by 2g, in that is 9.81, into y2 square will be equal to 2.12 meters, implies downstream water depth y2 will be equal to 1.654 meters, whereas upstream depth will be 2 meters.